annelida. They are cylindrical and divided into segments or metameres. They are bilaterally symmetrical, they are triploblastic and have organ system level of organization. They are metamerically segmented and coelomate. They have chitinous setae and lateral muscular appendages called parapodia for locomotion. So they have parapodia for locomotion. They have a true coelom, that is coelomate. Digestive tract is complete. They have digestive glands, metameric segmentation, true coelom, closed circulatory system and pumping heart appeared first in annelids. Digestive glands, metameric segmentation, true coelom, closed circulatory system and a pumping heart first appeared in annelids. Respiration. Through moist skin, that is cutaneous respiration, and through gills, that is brachial respiration. Circulatory system is closed. Blood is red with hemoglobin-like pigment. They have hemoglobin-like pigment called erythrocurcurin. They have RBCs are absent in them. Excretory organ is nephridia, which helps in osmoregulation. Excretory organ of annelid is nephridia, which helps in osmoregulation. Nervous system consists of a nerve ring, that is brain, and a solid, double, and a ventral nerve cord with ganglia. Reproduction is sexual, but Nereus is dioecious, but earthworms and leeches are monoecious. Development, it is direct or indirect with free-swimming ciliated trochophore larva. The examples are, number 1. So this is the difference between Nereus, which is sandworm, also called as ringworm, Ferectima, that is earthworm, and Hirudinaria, that is blood-sucking leech. So in Nereus the cephalization is present, in Ferentima earthworm cephalization is absent, and in Hirudinaria, that is blood-sucking leech, cephalization is absent. In Nereus, parapodia helps in locomotion. In Ferentima, setae helps in locomotion. But in Hirudinaria, parapodia and setae both are absent. Nereus, it is unisexual or dioecious. That is, male and female are separate, dioecious. In Ferentima, they are bisexual, hermaphrodite or monoecious. Hirudinaria, they are also bisexual, hermaphrodite or monoecious. In Nereus, the larva is trochophore. And in Hirudinaria, there is a special hirudin, which is an anticoagulant present. The other example is Aphrodite or sea mouse. So this is an example, this is also an example, and this is also an example. This is an example of Aphrodite, this is Nereus or sandworm or ringworm, and this is Hirudinaria, blood-sucking leech. So let's read what is given in NCERT. Phylum Annelida, they may be aquatic, marine and freshwater or terrestrial or free-living and sometimes parasitic. They exhibit organ system level of body organization and bilateral symmetry. They are triploblastic and they are metamerically segmented and coelomate animals. Their body surface is distinctly marked out into segments or metameres and hence the phylum is named Annelida, Latin annulus or little rings. They possess longitudinal as well as circular muscles which helps in locomotion. So longitudinal and circular muscles which helps in locomotion. They also have parapodia which also helps in locomotion. Nereus possesses lateral appendages, parapodia which helps in swimming. In Nereus, the parapodia helps in swimming. A closed circulatory system is present. Nephridia, singular nephridium. It helps in osmoregulation and excretion. So nephridia, it is the excretory system and it helps in osmoregulation and excretion. Neural system consists of paired ganglia, single ganglion, connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord. Nereus, an aquatic form, it is dioecious, that is sexes are separate, but earthworms and leeches are monoecious, means they are hermaphrodite. The reproduction is sexual in phylum Annelida. The examples of Annelida are Nereus, Ferentima, that is earthworm, and Hirudinaria, that is blood-sucking leech. Thank you.